Summarize column is the primary querying function used by Power BI. And the reason is, in summarize columns, with a single function call, you can specify most of the arguments of a typical query. You provide to summarize columns three kinds of arguments, which are the group by columns, the filters, and the column that you want to create in the output. Let's see that with an example. In this first example, I'm using summarize column and I specify the group by as group by columns the product brand and the calendar year. So summarize column will generate all the combination of brand and calendar year. Before doing that, it needs to apply the filters, which are specified in the next argument. Summarize column detects that an argument is a filter because it is a table. And in this case, I'm using three tiles to retrieve 2008 and 2009 as calendar year. Therefore, this table filters the date table for only the years, which are 2008 and 2009. Same is happening here with the second filter, that is filtering the product table where the color is either red or blue. So once the filter has been applied, summarize column generates the combinations of the group by column, and it finally computes the new column. In this case, they are amount and quantity. For each new column, I need to provide the column name and the expression that computes the column value. These expressions are evaluated in a filter context that contains the currently selected value of which is being iterated by summarize columns. So summarize columns, unlike summarize, relies only on the filter context. It generates no raw context, and this makes it much easier to use, because you don't have to worry about the interaction between the raw context and the filter context that create issues in Summarize. Summarize columns can also create new columns for new rows for the total, both new rows and new columns. If you want subtotals, you can specify that with one modifier, that is rollup addisSubtotal. In this case, I'm using rollup addisSubtotal, and I say that I want not only to group by brand, but I also want the subtotal at the brand level. And I also need to specify a new name. This is the name of a new column that contains a Boolean value, either true or false. It is true if the given row contains a subtotal at the given level. Because I'm requesting the subtotal both for the brand and for the year, you see that in the result I have additional rows. This one, for example, shows a blank for the brand, a value for the year, meaning that this is the subtotal at the brand level, and you can also tell it because the brand total column contains true. The same happens for the subtotals at the year level, that contains a true for the year total. They have a value for the brand and no value for the year. And finally, I have the grand total that contains true for all the total columns and no value for either the year and the brand. And this is the grand total. It is useful whenever you want to express in one single query not only the values of individual cells, but also the subtotals. And summarize columns is able to compute that. An important note about summarize columns is that rows that contain blank for all the measures are not returned as part of the result. In this case, I'm summarizing by calendar year and I'm computing the sales amount. Even though my data model contains years which happen to be before 2007 and also years which are after 2009, these values are not returned because sales amount there would return a blank. You can change this behavior using the ignore modifier. An important note about summarize columns, even though it's rather technical, is the behavior of autoexist. If you specify multiple filters as part of summarize columns and these filters operate on the same table, they are merged together before being applied. This behavior is known as autoexist and in some borderline scenarios might produce really hard to understand values. If you are interested in more details, you can go at reading this article that explains in greater detail all the details of autoexist. In this example, I'm using two filters on the date, one on the calendar year and one on the month. Even though the two filters are separate filters, they are actually joined together. So the two filters are merged and they represent only one filter on the date table. Multiple filters specified in summarize columns, if they operate on the same table, they are merged together because of autoexist. Finally, summarize column has a strong limitation that you need to be aware of. Summarize columns cannot be executed if there is a row context, or a filter context that was generated by context transition, or an arbitrarily shaped set in the filter context. This limitation is much harder to express than to actually obey, because it basically means that you cannot use summarize columns as part of a measure definition. Whatever measure you will author in Power BI, for example, that measure will be executed inside either a row context or a filter context generated by context transition, due to the way the client tool generates the query that produces the number that you are interested in looking at. Therefore, you can use summarize columns in a query, but you basically cannot use summarize columns as part of a measure. There, you will need to rely on summarize add columns and simpler function that can be executed in any kind of filter context. If you look at this example, I'm calling summarize columns inside an iteration over the values of calendar year. Therefore, there is a row context, and all what I obtain is an error that says that summarize column and add missing items cannot be used in this specific context.